So this is just a demonstration of using the Luminess Everyday Airbrushing Makeup Kit. Now the first thing, the couple things I'm going to be using is I'm going to be using the moisturizer and primer. I'll be using a shade 2, which came in my kit. This will be for like concealer. Then my foundation, which is number 3, Golden Beige. I also will be using a blush, which is N3. And then just a little bit of a highlight, which I'm using the Brightening Gold, which is G1. It did come with a bronzer, but what I've noticed is it makes me look a little too orangey using the bronzer. So the first thing that I need to do, and also too, I have the little bottle that has water in it, is you have to make sure that you shake up the products because they do separate. So I'm going to first start off with the moisturizer and primer in one. And the videos on the actual DVD that it comes with are informative enough to tell you what to do. So you'll put about 2 drops into the gun. 1, 2. And this doesn't have where you can set the PSIs to just push on off, so I'll be turning on. And there already is air coming out of it. This little doohickey is what you're going to be pulling back to actually spray the product on, and it'll feel like a cool wetness when it's actually sprayed. So you're supposed to keep it about 6 inches away from your face, and using your hand, just go in circular motions, keeping it moving all across the face and into your neck. And then I also do it on my eyes to help with the eyeshadow. Anything extra, you'll have a tissue paper you can just spray onto it till you hear there's nothing in it. You could turn off your air gun at this time frame. Now what you're going to do is we're going to conceal a little bit. So I'm taking my number 2, which is a little bit lighter, if I don't drop it. And for this, I'll be concealing a little bit of my spots. I have some acne spots and then a little bit of dark circles under my eyes. So for this, I'm going to use about 4 drops, and I'm going to conceal. So first I'm going to start off probably with my spots, where there's a little bit of redness. Under the chin, the spot right here, and on my nose. When it comes to under the eyes, you just have to be really careful when you're pulling back the actual gun and try not to spray yourself in the eye, which is always fun. You keep the gun moving, it'll make sure that the makeup itself goes on flawlessly and doesn't kind of put on cakey, because it is possible if you pull the gun too close or if you pull on the actual gun itself, the nozzle, it'll go on too much. Done. If you have any extra product in your gun, you obviously want to shoot that out into the paper towel or napkin or whatever you're using. Now I'm going to take my foundation, and I want probably a medium coverage. So what they talk about in there is layering. As you can see, that's like my trouble spots here. They aren't as dark as they were, but it's not completely covered, which I like a matte coverage, but whatever works. So again, taking my foundation, I have mine in Golden Beige, putting 6 drops in it. And I'm going to start with this. I'm going to start going from the right side of my face and kind of making circles going down. I'll make sure to hit my chin and neck, and then the other side. What I like about this, even though it is airbrush makeup and it is a little bit lighter coverage than I'm used to, is the fact that I can control it, but also too that it doesn't actually get into any of my hair, whether it is my actual regular hair or if it is my eyebrows, because I have noticed on other people do their videos that they've gotten some of the color into their actual brows. I'm gonna make sure you pull it down to the neck so that gets kind of blended as well. So this is the coverage after pretty much going using one application and going around. So when I start off on the right side and then worked my way to left, by the time that I had already gotten around to the other side of my face, the right side was already dry. So pretty much I was slightly layering. I probably have about 2 layers of the actual makeup product on. I'm actually going to do another layering just to have a little more of a matte finish. And then I will show you the rest of what I do for the face using these products. An important thing that you need to do when cleaning out your air gun, and I do it before I put any other color to get some of the foundation off, is you'll take a little bit of water, fill up the chamber about halfway, you'll turn on your gun, and you'll back bubble. So you'll hold the tip, and then you'll kind of do that until you see some bubbles. And then you'll take it with your paper towel and just spray until your spray is clear, which it just about is. And if you have any extra residue in there, you could take a Q-tip, turn off, and then clean out the chamber. Now for blush, same thing, that's still like the apples on your cheeks, so very light application of blush. You want it darker, you can always apply more, but I just want a nice healthy glow. And still, as you can see, I'm still going in circular motions doing this. The last thing that we need to put on is a little bit of the glow just to give that, like, I guess, dewy look. And I only put 2 drops in it, and so you're just going to put it on the highest points of where you would have your highlights, so right above the cheeks where your blush is. And then probably across the forehead just a little bit, and down the nose, and down the mouth, wherever you think needs highlighting. To give that nice soft glow. Just to finish off your face, I just combed a little bit of mascara through my brows, put on some colored mascara on my lashes, and then just a little bit of a shiny gloss. And there you have pretty much a basic everyday airbrushing look using the Luminous Everyday Air Kit. So I hope you guys have found this like demonstration helpful, and if you have any questions, don't hesitate to ask. Check out Luminessair for more information about this kit and its other products. Until next time, besos, bye.